was really pleased that Channel 4 had picked up Crufts. I understand that there are issues with breeding and overbreeding of dogs, and I do realise that it's causing cruelty issues that the RSPCA are concerned about. But I think the dog world is such a massive world, it's an interesting world, and I was really pleased when it was on Channel 4.
So, one born every minute, I sit watching, my girlfriend hates it, covering her eyes, or I sit laughing, find it quite amusing.
Absolutely, from a gentleman who's got no children, taking the conversation to work, speaking to ladies who have got children, it just really goes to show boys and girls have very different opinions on what happens in childbirth, particularly which end you want to stand at.
And Rob's a doctor.
Not a real doctor, I'm a dentist.
The Cleveland Show, half an hour of pointless humour with an advert in the middle, buy Family Guy. Spend a little bit more money, get the Family Guy. Brilliant. Cleveland Show, pointless.
Shameless is a great comedy documentary. First series we thought was really lifelike. In fact, we almost mistook it for a documentary. But the last series is probably a little bit lightweight for me. It's almost glamorised it a little bit. Still funny though, but not quite as good as the first one.
I have got every single DVD made for Shameless, every single series. It has got a bit close to the bone for the younger generation. It's getting a bit heavy.
I've watched the past few series of Shameless, and the last series lately about the psychosis story. It's been quite interesting, but I think it's not been as good as the first few series. I think the main comedy factor has been removed.
Skins has gone a little bit downhill, I think. I enjoyed the series one and two the best, but the characters like Cook make it pretty interesting.
I thought the latest series of Skins was pretty good. It was fairly dark, but it went with the whole theme of the programme. I don't think the episode where Freddie was murdered was too shocking, because it sort of, it fitted in well with the storyline.
Coach, it's good fun. It reminds me of some of my parents' holidays. Good fun, unbelievable in fact, actually.
I watch one programme on Channel 4 and it's the news and it's brilliant.
I'm here watching the rugby, which I'd much prefer to see more of on Channel 4. Hopefully they'll stop doing all that silly racing. Coming from Swindon, I've watched Come Dine With Me, and it only went to prove just how dire some people's dinners are. But seriously, I do watch Dispatches, and I think that they're really great programmes because they do what Panorama used to do, which is really dig around and give you some unbiased information.
To be honest, Dispatches, if you want to find out anything, okay, and you want it independent, okay, Dispatches. Okay.
Having watched Dispatches, Cameron Uncovered, my personal opinion was that it was almost trying to make him look like someone that people might want to vote for, but personally I feel that it actually had an adverse effect. I think it tried to dumb down showing any bias towards him, and therefore I think that's possibly why it got the reaction from me that it did.
Secret Millionaire I found was quite interesting. It's amazing, A, how many millionaires there are, and that they're prepared to put their time and effort into looking at the way that other people live and trying to give them a hand in life as well.
I've learned so much from Embarrassing Bodies. It's by far, I mean, it gives men confidence to go talk to doctors, stuff like that. It makes you feel comfortable going to the doctors. And if you've got a problem, you know what I mean, it's one of those things. It gives that little bit of want to go.